Somebody pray for me. It been a day for me. Yeah.
Yo, what is up, YouTube? It's your boy Shubinati, aka Grown Bat, with another vid. Alright, man, you got your lies off. You happy? Now let's speak the truth. Let's get to the facts. Let's debunk the bullshit claims that he has made. First, let's start with the Air Jordan 12 bread flu game. Look at this photo up on the screen, guys. The top photo is DMD on his Instagram page in a picture holding the bread 12s. He actually deleted this picture as well. That's automatically admission to guilt. And the bottom photo is Champion Kicks pair on DMD's video that he claimed was fake. Take a look at the circle area. Same exact factory flaws. The bottom photo is Champion Kicks pair from DMD's video, and the top photo is DMD's picture on his Instagram page of him wearing the sneakers. Look at the factory flaw. Same factory flaw, same area. Checkmate. D, you're a lying scumbag, man. It's blatantly obvious that you stole Champion Kicks pairs of sneakers, man. Just admit it, be honest, man. We got you, dawg. Same fucking sneakers. Look at it again, guys. The top is DMD holding the pair of bread 12s, same factory flaw. The bottom is Champion Kicks pair of sneakers from DMD's own video. We got you, man. It's the same pair of sneakers. And that's why he deleted the photo off of his Instagram page. He put the proof up against himself. Goof ass nigga. You thought you deleted it, but it still got screenshotted. You a piece of shit, and you're blatantly caught. Now lie your way out of this. On to the next lie. Next, let's get down to this bullshit where he's speaking on my wife. Me and my wife got in a little squabble. We were arguing and it got recorded on a live. Yes, it did get recorded. No, I did not put my hands on my wife. Yes, we were bickering about a petty ass little $100. It was some personal bullshit beef, but that's nothing. I got over $250 in cash right now and I have over $1,200 in my bank account. I don't give a fuck about $100. That ain't no fucking money, and that's my wife. She can get whatever she want. That's my queen. She half of me. So if she want all the money, she can get it. That's my wife. I don't give a fuck what niggas gotta say about that. That's personal, so he can feel any kind of way he want to, but I know deep down that's just a deflection, and he only got that footage from bitch ass Mr. Skinny making that bullshit up so he could clout ride and try to create some bullshit content. Mr. Skinny is a fake ass dude. Every time he get around someone, he cool with them for a minute and then he snake them. He snake Davey, he snake Feats and Treats. He's just a snake ass nigga, and anybody who around him, I automatically don't trust you. You're putting yourself in harm's way just by even being around his fake ass. So if you wanna roll with him, just make sure you stay away from me. Next, let's speak on this clout chasing thing. D, you only have 117K. Your growth is anemic. You hit over 100K almost a year ago, and you've only gained about 17,000 more subscribers since. Dude, you not popping like that, fam. I live in Atlanta. I live around Tony, Mike Rich, T-Ward, Sniper Jones, One Leg Lister. If I was going to clout chase anyone, I fuck with Tony. I could just pick up the phone and be like, let's do videos, Tony. Let's do videos, Tony. Let's do videos, Tony. He got 4 times the amount of subscribers you do. So if I was gonna clout chase anyone, I would just rock with Tony. And we did a couple videos in the past, but anybody who know me, I stand on my own as a man. I ain't riding no nigga dick. Either I get it or I don't at the end of the day. And I've been doing this before you, so I'm definitely not gonna clout chase anyone. And if I was gonna clout chase anybody, it wouldn't be your punk ass. Nigga, you only got a little over 100K. YouTubers been hitting past 100K since like 2014, 2015. You ain't talking about shit, dog. You ain't nobody like that. Plus, like I said, the growth on your channel is anemic. D, you only have 117K. We have people who have 1 million subs now. Like, you're subpar, dog. And the way you're making content and the way your edits are, you'll never see 250,000. You'll never see 500,000. You'll never see 1 million. So let's stop flexing like you PewDiePie and your content whack, dog. You're not good at editing. I've been doing this. I'm for real with this. Just because the masses didn't know me doesn't mean I'm not credible to this community. So please stop lying. Next, let's go back to the origin of my channel. I started in 2014. I didn't tag videos, I didn't know about the algorithm, I didn't have thumbnails. It was a lot I didn't know. And YouTube is based off of the metrics of your channel from the very beginning. If you're not uploading consistently, if you're not doing things right, if you're not tagging videos, if you don't got thumbnails, YouTube is going to judge you based off the beginning of your channel. So if you're not doing it right, even if you fix it up later and you keep it going, what you've done in the past is still going to hurt the growth of your channel. YouTube was not promoting my videos. You can go check in the past. I've been dropping heat after heat after heat and been getting low amount of views because YouTube is judging me off the origin of my channel compared to what I've been doing these last few years. And like I said, that's okay with me. I'm about love for this culture, love for sneakers, love for the community, love for the game. It's not all about the views, dog, or all about the sub count. Like I always say, fuck the subscriber count. That doesn't matter. How many people are watching your videos? It's about the views. Views bring money. If you ain't getting the views, it don't matter. And like I said, if I'm not getting the views, that's fine. If the community as a whole don't rock with me, that's cool. I still love making sneaker content anyway. I'm still plugged. I still get early access to a lot of good sneakers. And I love making content. I love editing. And I love the entire process. I'm true to this game. I might not have the subs you have, but I love it. And I'm not a fucking scammer. And that's all that really matter to me. Next, let's be real, D. You don't have no fucking shoes, dog. I'm pulling out Fear Gods, Sean Witherspoons, Off-Whites. Dog, go check the playlist last year. I unboxed a bunch of sneakers. I touch a lot of heat that the average person can't even get. I get it legitly and I flip, man. Some kicks I keep, some kicks I sell. But ultimately, nigga, you ain't having no heat like that. I didn't see you with no major shit last year. Nigga, you mostly touch GRs. Nigga, you walking through the mall. These are shitting ducks. Nigga, you ain't buying nothing. You ain't coming out of pocket, cheap ass nigga. You not fooling nobody, B. You might have had a chance to hit on those satins because they were dropped exclusively in Houston and in very few states. But nigga, you not touching no heat like that. You mainly touching GRs. So let's keep it real, fam. Plus, let's be clear. I live in a 4-bedroom house with my wife and 2 dogs. I have a job and a couple side hustles. You have 100K in a PayPal account, but you live in an apartment. Stop lying. You're a fuckboy. Next, let's talk about these fake ass giveaways you doing. So I heard about a giveaway you was doing off your whole weight loss challenge. People could enter, sign up for your program. If whoever loses the most weight will get a free pair of shoes. Well, you announced the winner one time, but you continue to do it. So where's the drawing for the rest of the winners? What happened to the people who signed up and lost weight, but you didn't announce who else had won sneakers? You scamming through giveaways, man? Just trying to get people to sign up for your little weight loss program? You so plastic, dog. You see through. Any real motherfucker can see through you. No matter what you say out your mouth, your actions prove who you are. Cause this is real life. Fuck what you talking about. What do you do? That is the measure of a man. It doesn't matter what you say. Your actions show who you are. And your actions have showed that you're a lying, scamming piece of shit. And last but not least, this is not about me. This is about you being a man, you being held accountable, your reputation, you being responsible for the responsibility that comes with this platform. You have been stealing from people, and we have proof. You have been taking advantage of the public. You've been saying one thing and you've been doing something else. And we have proof of it. Let alone you running around trying to bully people and talk shit and call people out and you the one who's stealing from the public? Like, you a piece of shit. And like I said, I'm gonna continue to slap you across the face. I'm gonna continue to bury you. I'm gonna dig you up and I'm gonna bury you again. I'm gonna dig you up, I'm gonna do another autopsy, and I'm gonna bury you again until you off of this fucking platform because you're a lying, scamming piece of shit. And more people are emailing me with more proof. So part 4 is on the way, man. More facts. Fuck all that jokes and talking shit and just saying shit. I'm coming with receipts. I'm coming with proof. And there's no way you can deny it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, comment, subscribe. Let's continue to put the pressure on this bitch ass nigga. Hashtag ScamD. The saga continues. Surviving Damn D part 2. More videos is coming. Of course, I'm gonna continue to hit you guys with that sneaker unboxings and more heat as usual. But stay tuned while I keep cooking this bum ass nigga. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, hit that thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Illuminate. So you know how we do about this time. It's grown and I approve this message. Intangible Entertainment. We famous, bitch. It's grown. I'm gone. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Ain't nothing like money in a Ziploc bag.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. That's right.
Smash with the cash. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Ain't nothing like money in a Ziploc bag. Smash with the cash. Intangible entertainment. We famous, bitch.